expected, there are more water rescues, at least 2,000 so far. People who believe they would wait it out or that the water would go down are realizing they have to get out. On a downtown street in Houston, an elderly man pushes his wife in a wheelchair. Both wear trash bags for ponchos as they walk from an arena that was turned into... They are Mel and Barbara Meekan, rescued last night by a Bel Air Fire Department boat.
And we had knee-deep water in our house, so we're here.
We were at Cross Point Church in Bel Air, and we had a Metro bus come and pick just about everybody up. Even the Army was out there with their big trucks, and they were bringing us to the Coliseum over here. Now we have a hotel, so that's where we're going now.
Oh, good. Where are you going?
Doubletree.
Mayor Sylvester Turner said at a press conference today that about 5,500 people have been brought to emergency shelters in the city. He stressed what's obvious to anyone driving the few passable streets. The city is still very much in a rescue mode.
That's the major focus for the day. That's my directive, is that we want to focus on getting people where they are and getting them out of their homes or whatever their stressful situation may be.
All over Houston, you see what's being called the Texas Navy. Private citizens pulling their fishing boats behind pickups. They're launching their vessels at the water's edge, which could be anywhere that a street becomes a bayou. County Judge Ed Emmett put out an extraordinary call yesterday. He said the fire department, Coast Guard, and police are overwhelmed. They need people to help their neighbors. And folks have responded. Ray Ortega, an oil field tool salesman, drove up from his home in Victoria pulling a 23-foot fishing boat that he usually uses in the Gulf to go after speckled trout and redfish.
I've been able to rescue 10, 15 people at a time. Yesterday was a very good day for us. We rescued 53 people into the night.
Where are you going to go today?
We're just trying to find somewhere we can launch this boat and save some people.
The Army Corps of Engineers announced that it will open floodgates and release water from two major reservoirs that are perilously full from the tropical deluge. This is expected to push Buffalo Bayou, which flows through the middle of Houston, even higher. Some worry that will cause the flooding to get even worse. That's why brothers Jay and Manuel Cano came out with their green rowboat to rescue a relative stranded in the flooded Denver Harbor neighborhood.
We got my wife's sister in there without no light and water since all this started. So we're going to see if we can talk her to get out.
And you got a little John boat here.
Yes, sir. You brought oars, right?
Yeah, I brought oars. I brought a rope.
Okay, let me get this thing turned around.
One of the most maddening problems that Houston is facing is the vast acreage of the city that's gone underwater. This makes it difficult, if not impossible, to get around. Larry Hall, a juvenile probation officer with Harris County, drove down a street where the water came up to his bumpers, then turned around in frustration.
I live in Crosby, and I'm just trying to find my way home. I left my job over there off of Chimney Rock, off of 59, and I've been driving for the last 3 hours trying to figure out how to make it back in that direction.
Meanwhile, the National Weather Service reports that Harvey is expected to produce 15 to 25 inches of additional rainfall over the upper Texas coast and into southwestern Louisiana through Friday. Some isolated totals may exceed 4 feet of rain. John Burnett, NPR News, Houston.
And joining us now is Harris County Judge Ed Emmett. He's the top elected official for the county that includes Houston, and he directs emergency management services there. Judge Emmett, thank you for making the time today.
Good afternoon.
I'd like to begin with the decision you made not to evacuate Harris County and therefore the city of Houston. At a news conference on Friday, you said evacuations for water are usually related to storm surge rather than rain. Let's hear just a bit of that press conference.
At this time, I can reemphasize, there will be no mass evacuations called. We'll have a lot of water, but it's not the kind of water that we would ask people to evacuate from.
Judge Emmett, was that the right decision?
Yes, it was. Looking at it now, you say, my goodness, those of us who remember the evacuation in front of Hurricane Rita, it was an absolute nightmare. It was chaos, and many, many people died on the roads. The other situation, the difference is when a storm surge comes, you know where it's going to hit. You know which neighborhoods you need to evacuate. If it's an 8-foot storm surge, we have zones. We can say how high it's going to come up on land, and we evacuate those people. In a rain event like this, a very significant rain event, matter of fact, this is a 1,000-year rain event by everybody's measure, you don't know which neighborhoods are going to be affected, so you would, in essence, have to evacuate the entire region, not just Harris County, Galveston County, Brazoria County, Fort Bend County. You're talking about almost 7 million people. that's just not, and where would those 7 million go? There aren't shelters set up for them. It would not have been something that people would have taken kindly to, shall we say.
Right now we're hearing of people...
And it wouldn't have been the right thing.
Right now we're hearing of people waiting hours on hold with 911. Do you have a sense of how big the backlog is of demand for urgent emergency response?
I don't at this time. I know it was bad. We have, in Harris County and City of Houston, we have three large 911 call centers. But again, this is an event that's absolutely unprecedented. And we are pulling people out as fast as possible, first responders. It was complicated even more. The state sent resources, National Guard and Texas Task Force 1, but they couldn't get through the high water either to get here. So that's when I put out the call for private residents, if they had boats, to come help and coordinate it through us.
And more rain is coming, which means more people will need rescuing. So is help on the way, or should people expect to fend for themselves?
That's not necessarily true. More rain is coming. The areas that have flooded are flooded. And now National Guard is here. Texas Task Force 1 is here, and we are working as fast as we can to remove all those people out of harm's way.
So if people are concerned about rising water where they are, is help on the way, or are they more or less going to have to fend for themselves or hope that a neighbor stops by?
Well, as I just said, help is already here. The National Guard is now here. Texas Task Force 1 is now here. Many, many private folks are also here assisting the first responders. We are pulling people out. Houston Police Department, Sheriff's Office, Constables, National Guard, everybody is full at it, and we're getting that number down as rapidly as we can.
Our reporters are describing shelters that do not have enough food, that are already overcrowded. If more people show up to those shelters, will there be enough cots for them? Will there be food for them?
There will be, but the same circumstance applies. The Houston Food Bank was surrounded by water, and so therefore trucks couldn't get in and out in order to deliver food to the Red Cross shelters.